Well, an opportunity came up. There was an open seat in my district, and I had been encouraged in the past to run, but I'd always deferred. But I decided that I have a lifetime of experience that I could put to use in Juneau. I work with a lot of different people. I'm able to get along with a lot of different folks. And I thought that perhaps I could come in as someone who's never run before. I'm not a politician, and thought I'd give it a try. When I first came up here in 1975, I earned about $7 an hour in my first job, and I paid an income tax. It was 20% of the federal income tax, and it wasn't onerous. It was doable. I was still able to make a living, and I think we may need to go back to that. I think using the permanent fund dividend is regressive, and I don't agree with children having to pay for the mistakes of adults in their PFD. So I recognize we may need to use a PFD, but I'm not as much in favor of that as instigating an income tax, which I'd also like to be able to tax the folks who live up here, or not live up here, who fly up here, who live in other states. They work on the slope and then they go back home, and they don't pay anything into the state coffers. Well, as I stated earlier, I would advocate for an income tax. I think that is fair to Alaskans. Well, I think one of the first things I'd like to see done is I'd like to see treatment facilities for drug addictions and alcohol addictions. I think those are fueling a lot of the crime that's going on. I know there's been a lot of debate about SB 91. Obviously there are problems that need to be solved. It needs to go back to the drawing board, perhaps, and done over. Well, treatment. I think we need treatment facilities, and we're already paying for these people in emergency services. So I would rather pay up front and get the problem treated than putting it off to see people in emergency rooms or in jails. Anyway, that's what I would like to see done. Balancing the budget. That is one of the biggest things, and crime.
Do you believe human activity is changing Alaska's climate, and what responsibility do lawmakers have to respond to environmental changes affecting the state?
I do believe we are responsible for environmental changes. I worry about what's happening in the bush, where the communities are losing their villages to the ocean, and what I see with my own eyes when we go boating out in Prince William Sound, and we've watched the glaciers receding quite a bit in the last few years, and Portage Glacier, and I think we should start developing alternative resources for energy, and I think we need to start doing something to improve the environment just to make it a better planet for our children and grandchildren. I'd like to diversify. I think we could develop renewable resources, for one. There's a gentleman working for one of the oil companies who's putting in a solar panel farm. And we could perhaps have, called cloud storage, where they have facilities that store information, and a cold climate is a good thing for that. Those are some of my ideas. I do. I've been reading a lot about it lately. I am somewhat reserved in listening to all the commercials I hear about Stand for Alaska, because it sounds like they're trying to make it sound horrible. A lot of the companies that are supporting Stand for Alaska are the big oil companies, and one of them, I still remember the Exxon Valdez. And we love salmon. People come up to Alaska to pay to catch salmon. They're our best renewable resource. And I came from the state of Washington originally, where every year we used to go fishing on the coast for salmon. And those salmon are gone now. I would hate to see that happen in Alaska.